Okay, hello guys, this is Igor MGTOW and the video games, and today we're going to be talking about the rising STD rates and the epidemic rates, especially in the female population and in the future. And these reasons will lead you to become even more MGTOW-like monk mode. So let's see, public health workers taking action on rising STD rates, gonorrhea, syphilis making comebacks. Well, we MGTOWs all know the answer, but we won't hate it. In January, Philadelphia public health workers began offering 3 weeks of syphilis testing at drop-in centers where women who are homeless can get food, clothing, and a hot shower. No such thing for men, I guess. Because women are better. But men don't need it because they don't have such cases. The work is in a response to a recent spike in local syphilis cases among women. So when men get such things, they don't care. But when women even get a minor local rise, everything is hell. EPHA member Sherry Walker Babin, program manager in the Philadelphia Department of Public Health STD Control Program, said health workers have been preparing for the possibility as syphilis uptakes often accompany additional epidemics such as the current opioid crisis. Well, wonder why. More and more women become conspicuous and then F with more and more chads and go to the cock carousel. Then they make up problems as to how problematic this is, and then they have STD problems, and then they revolt. So in actuality, it's their own fault for basically making this entire crisis. So basically, let's now check. So let's see. In fact, she said partnering with local drop-in centers is the same strategy health workers used in 1999 to contain a syphilis uptick during the crack cocaine epidemic. It's never-ending. Walker Babin said of the STD prevention and control, "We may not see a disease for a while, but when it shows its head, we have to go full force at it so it doesn't get out of control. Regardless of what funding we have. Because throwing more money is the perfect solution instead of telling women not to F unprotected with many men and not to F with many men." Unfortunately, syphilis is just one of the sexual transmitted diseases making a comeback from across the country. You wonder why? It's because of the women fucking too much times. Then not doing any safety precautions, and then they have disease problems. Between 2013 and 2017, cases of gonorrhea increased 60-70%. If women continue the way they are doing right now, 5 years from now, half of the population might have some sort of STD or STI infection. And now they are reaping what they sow. So 20 men to avoid this kind of thing, and since some women don't care if they are disease ridden, I suggest you men don't even pump it up. At this point, go full monk mode or almost monk mode. Just do it. There's no way other than that to save yourself. Syphilis has more than doubled among women because of dating apps and all these other gynocentric bullshit and the support of the cock carousel. Well, it's their own fault. Cases of congenital syphilis pass from woman to baby, which can result in a miscarriage, infant death, and lifelong health problems. See? Where is this line which people who try to shame men use? It's called, but you're taking yourself out of the gene pool by going MGTOW. By this article, the gene pool suggests the gene pool is riddled with diseases, and it's a cesspool. Better leave it than be in a cesspool with diseases. And there is another thing. Chlamydia is still the country's most common STD, with 1.7 million diagnosed cases. And keep in mind, we're talking about the US, not Serbia. Despite the rising rates, federal funding in STD prevention has failed to keep at top, because you gotta throw money at it. In the December report from the National Public Academy of Public Administration, the impact of sexually transmitted diseases on the United States still hidden, getting worse, can be controlled. Author said that even though the funding for CDC's division of STD prevention has leveled for the past few years at about 157 million, failing to adjust for inflation means the division's purchasing power has gone 40% since 2003. According to Matthew Pryor, MPV Director of Communication at the National Coalition for STD Directors. Oh yes, they want to respond to the STD epidemic because it's affecting women. And now the government has to step up because women made the problem. We're very optimistic that the field will eventually get the resources it needs to address the problem. I beg to differ because men don't want to provide for women's own mistakes. They either have to solve their own problems or live with their own decisions. And it's typical that women don't want to deal with their own mistakes. So, of course, they'll have to live with it. And then there are some women who use their own... There are some women who use their own infection to lure in men to infect men. And now California has turned from felony to misdemeanor. So that's a bad idea. So MGTOWs, avoid pump and dumping at all costs. Because I don't think it will be a good idea. There's no one thing that's going to change it. Zan Fry and the Infectious Disease Field Services Coordinator at Washington State Department told the National Health. Any effort will do a better job with better resources, but we still have a lot of work to do around building sexual health and education services into contexts which people live in and which they seek health care. Well, it's their own problem. Women should pay for their own health care if they get infected with diseases. They chose their promiscuous, cock carousel riding lifestyle, and they have to live with it. Anyways, this is just my take on this entire future STD epidemic and why you should go up promoting MGTOW. Anyways, this was just my take. Subscribe, like this video, and hit the bell if you haven't already done so. Anyways, this is Igor MGTOW Games, and bye bye.